Happy Wednesday, First Baptist family. This is the last Wednesday of the 2020, and gosh, a lot of people are glad to see 2020 leaving. We've learned a lot of lessons this year. They have not been easy lessons. They've been challenging, and we're going to learn some more lessons this Sunday. We're going to learn from some of our young folks as we gather around this pulpit area, the platform area, with four of our college students who are going to talk to us about what's it like to be in college in the COVID crisis. I think you're going to be inspired by them. Some of you have taught them some from the time they were just little bitty kids, and we've watched them grow into fantastic young adults, and we'll get to share in the benefits of what they're learning in this COVID college crisis time right now. In the meantime, I want to remind you that we are online only from now until at least January 17th. Now, I know that if you watch Sunday, both Danny and I mentioned that we're online and in person next week. Well, we're not. That was recorded before the governor's mandate. We're having to do a lot of pre-recording these days because of some editorial needs to make things look as good as possible. So sometimes we may make a mistake and we'll put it down at the bottom of the Facebook crawl like Helen did this week. We'll do something to make sure you know. But for the time being, until January 17, we are online only at 9 a.m. and 11 a.m. each Sunday morning. Now, you can watch later, as you know. You can also join us on Wednesday afternoon when we do a little update for each week. There's a lot of things going on in the life of our church, a lot of Zoom classes happening right now, just some opportunities for us to continue to grow in these unusual times. So what are you looking forward to in a new year? Well, a lot of us are looking forward to a vaccine. We're looking forward to being able to say goodbye to COVID-19. Aren't you among that number? We're also looking forward to getting back to normal. I'm looking forward to seeing hundreds of you back in this room singing praises to God, studying God's word, and going out and doing ministry in the name of Jesus Christ. But we're still a little bit away from some of that. So in the meantime, here's a verse of scripture from Ephesians chapter 4. It's from the Message. It's down in verses 22, 23, and 24. And here's what it says. And then take on an entirely new way of life, a God-fashioned life, a life renewed from the inside and working itself into your conduct as God accurately reproduces his character in you. Wouldn't that be a great goal for each of us to have? A new life in 2021, not just because of a vaccine or because we're going to say goodbye to COVID, I hope and pray, but because internally we're being changed into the kind of people God wants us to become. I'm so proud of our college students who are going to reflect that on Sunday. There are dozens of other college students in our church who would do equally well. There are a lot of youth in our church who are learning the grace of God every Sunday. They're senior adults who continue to learn how to love God completely and fully. Maybe this year our prayer should be, God, work a new life in me. If so, no matter what else happens in 2021, it will be a year worth living. Now let's pray. Lord God, be near us as we enter a new year. Thank you for the lessons we've learned, even in challenge. Thank you for your strength and your peace, which have been there for us, even when we didn't see them. Thank you that you're going ahead of us into 2021, preparing the way for us to be your ambassadors. Help us to use every day of this year and next to your glory. Through Jesus' name we pray. Amen.